Hello friends, welcome to this session of research methodology. Up to this point, we have studied scientific method, scientific principles and research study designs. Now, in this session, we are going to study experiment. And as we have discussed in previous sessions, experiment is the research method where experimenter or researcher actively control at least one variable. Before starting detailed discussion on experiments, we'll study definition of experiment because definition will limit our discussion. An experiment is a procedure carried out to support, refute or validate a hypothesis. Now this definition puts hypothesis before experiment. You need to have hypothesis, and when you have hypothesis, you will design experiment according to your hypothesis to prove or to reject the hypothesis. Then second definition is, experiment is a scientific procedure undertaken to make a discovery, test a hypothesis or demonstrate a known fact. Here the explorations are also included in experiment. Okay. Demonstration of a known fact is also there, like Michael Faraday's experiment where he knew that lightning is there. He performed the experiment of a kite to which he attached a string which is conductive and proved that electricity is there in the sky, in the thunderbolts. Then next definition is, perform a scientific procedure especially in laboratory to determine something. Then another method of experiment, that is very general method, that is try out new ideas or methods. Try out new ideas or method. Here also trying is there. Researcher is actively engaged in manipulating the variables. Then an operation or procedure carried out under controlled condition in order to discover an unknown effect or law, to test or establish a hypothesis or to illustrate a known law. Okay. Here experiment is a procedure which is carried out to discover an unknown effect, to find out an unknown effect. To carry out that effect, researcher has to do something. Then a law may be there, unknown law may be there, observations may be there. Based on those observations, the researcher will design a hypothesis, and that hypothesis will be unknown till that point, but researcher will perform experiment to discover that law. Then to test or establish a hypothesis, again according to his observations, his or her observations, researcher has a hypothesis and he wants to establish that or not. Support known law also, or support known facts also, experiments are carried out. The next definition is a test or trial or a tentative procedure, an act or operation for the purpose of discovering something unknown or of testing a principle, supposition, etc. Everywhere they are these definitions are discussing that researcher has to prove something, to find out something, to discover something, to test something. And based on those definitions, we'll discuss further now. And this is the significance of experiments. Experiments provide insight into cause and effect by demonstrating what outcome occurs when a particular factor is manipulated. Is manipulated. In experiment, manipulation is necessary. I am deliberately repeating this statement that in experiment, researcher has control over at least one variable. And experiments provide insight into cause and effect. One variable will be changed, and effect on other variables, effect on response variables, we'll discuss that term later on, will be demonstrated. Then another thing which is very necessary to understand about experiments is, experiments vary greatly in goal and scale. Experiments can be very small also, like you may have seen in Wikipedia discussion of experiments, the photo of a child touching the mirror or kissing the mirror. The child was performing a very smaller experiment to know what is the taste of the mirror. Similarly, small experiments can be performed, like we can change an ingredient in our tea to test what effect is there on taste, or we can change an ingredient in a medium, growth medium for bacteria, and test what will be the effect on growth of the bacteria. Or experiments can be very large, can span over many years, like evolution of E. coli. When a great experiment is going on, E. coli is being cultivated and is transferred from day to day to different media, to similar media, and rate of mutations or occurrence of mutations is tested there, is studied there. Okay. Such large experiments can also be there. But all these experiments rely on repeatable procedure. Okay. Each experiment shall be reproducible. That procedure shall be repeatable, and logical analysis of the results is very necessary. Okay. If another researcher wants to try the experiment carried out by researcher, then that repetition shall be possible. This is another very important concept about experiments, that is significance of control. Controls are very necessary in experiment. Many people will be there, those will doubt, and doubting or criticizing or critically asking questions about results of an experiment or results of an observation or something, that's the basis of scientific principle, scientific method. Okay. Criticality, criticism is very essential. Doubt shall be there, question shall be there. And to make that answering those questions possible, controls are necessary. Controls are designed to minimize the effect of variables other than the single independent variable. And what controls? The word control tells us that that is manipulated by experimenter or manipulated by researcher. Researcher has control over that. Okay. These controls are designed to minimize the effects of variables which are not under study. Okay. Effect of those variables, control variables, are not sought out. The single independent variable is the variable of importance, is the variable of which effect is to be determined. Therefore, controls are designed to minimize the effect of other variables. Then, controls increases the reliability of the results, and often through comparison between control measurements and the other measurements. Other measurements will be the test measurements or treatment measurements. Then, scientific controls are a part of the scientific method, very essential part of scientific method. Very well designed experimental procedure is required to prove something. Okay. That can be a hypothesis, that can be a discovery, that can be a scientific principle, but controls are necessary. Controls is basis of scientific method. Ideally, all variables in an experiment are controlled, accounted for by the control measurements, and none are uncontrolled. That is ideally, but most of the time ideal things are not possible. In such an experiment, if all controls work as expected, it is possible to conclude that the experiment works as intended, if controls work as expected, and the results are due to the effect of the tested variable. Those controls shall not behave aberrantly, shall not behave uncontrolled. The experimenter or researcher shall have control over all the variables which are not to be tested, effect of which is not expected. Therefore, if those controls, like temperatures, if we fix a temperature in an incubator and want to study effect of pH on growth of bacteria, then that control shall work throughout the experiment. If temperature changes, fluctuates during the experiment, then the results are due to the effect, may not say that results are due to the effect of the tested variable. If all controls remain controlled, then only we can prove that the outcome is the effect of the manipulated variable or test variable, treatment variable. Then scientific method is there. In the scientific method, and here we are discussing a relation between experiment and scientific method. In the scientific method, an experiment is an empirical procedure. It's an empirical procedure that arbitrates competing models or hypotheses. Many different competing models are there, hypotheses are there, and experiment is there which will try to mediate something, which will try to prove one hypothesis over others. Okay. And try to find out the which of the hypothesis is true one or which of the competing models is true one. Then researchers also use experimentation to test existing theories or new hypotheses. Okay. Existing theories, existing hypotheses, existing beliefs, all can be tested, all can be supported or corroborated by the experimentation. And new hypotheses can be tested or proved by using experiments. Sometimes hypotheses can be disproved. That proving and disproving is going on. And that's the basis of scientific method. I again repeat. Then next significance of experiment in scientific method is an experiment usually tests a hypothesis, which is an expectation. Hypothesis is an expectation about how a particular process or phenomenon works. Throughout the course of our research methodology, we will go on repeating some things. We may go on changing the words also, or we may go on paraphrasing the specific terms, very important terms. And that's necessary to understand that concept from all its facets. Here, hypothesis is defined as it is an expectation about how a particular process or phenomenon works. That is the expectation that this shall happen. Okay. If hypothesis is that if we give paracetamol, the fever shall decrease down. Okay. That is the expectation that paracetamol shall decrease fever. Okay. And now, by giving paracetamol to a patient, we'll try to find out whether actually fever decreases or not. Then somebody may ask us question that this effect is not due to paracetamol, this effect is due to other factors. Okay. Therefore, we'll make two groups. One group will be control group to which we'll give placebo, and other group is the test group to which we'll give paracetamol. And fever shall decrease only in paracetamol and fever shall not decrease in the other group. Both groups shall be matched properly. Both groups shall have on an average shall be similar to each other. Okay, then only we can say that effect of paracetamol is there, because only difference in these two groups shall be the paracetamol. Okay. However, an experiment may also aim to answer a what if question. What will happen if we do this? That question. Without a specific expectation about what the experiment reveals, or to confirm prior results. Sometimes hypothesis may not be there. And very sometimes, what will happen if we inject potassium chloride to a rat? What will happen if we inject potassium chloride to a rat? That can be a question. We may not have any expectation about what will happen, whether the rat will die, or whether the rat will become more energetic, whether the rat will gain weight, or whether the rat will suffer diarrhea. We don't know. Okay. Just we want to find out what is happening. Therefore, we'll have two groups. One group will be provided with placebo, and other group will be provided with potassium chloride solution of desired dose. Okay. And sometimes experiment can be carried out to confirm prior results also. Somebody may have done the experiment, may have described the experimental procedure. We will repeat that procedure by keeping all the procedural aspects same, and we'll try to find out whether the results are same as discussed by the original experimenter. Then, if an experiment is carefully conducted, the results usually either support or disprove the hypothesis. Is carefully conducted, that is very essential. Therefore, for conducting experiment, a good planning is necessary. A very systematic planning is necessary. According to some philosophies of science, an experiment can never prove a hypothesis. That philosophy is there. And I leave that to you to explore this thing further. An experiment can never prove a hypothesis. It can only add support. Okay. And whenever a contradictory result comes, then that hypothesis will be rejected. There is always a possibility for rejection of hypothesis. Therefore, I urge you or request you to understand this statement further by exploring yourself. On the other hand, an experiment that provides a counter example can disprove a theory or hypothesis. Okay. But a theory can always be salvaged by appropriate ad hoc modifications at the expense of simplicity. Okay. A theory is a very well established scientific principle or scientific hypothesis. It's very well established, very well proved. But if an experiment or some new observation disproves something of that theory, then that theory can always be salvaged, can always be saved by making modifications or by changing the statement of the theory. And that statement will reduce down the simplicity of the theory, like E is equal to mc square. Okay. It's a very simple theory, but many a times we may have observations or scientists may have discovered something that will modify that theory, that theory of relativity, and the theory is going towards the universal theory just because of some new additions to it, and that those new additions are reducing simplicity. Now we are going towards the quantum thing. I'm not very well versed with physics, but that universal theory is always going on changing, and is always being saved or salvaged by adding something to it, and that is reducing the simplicity. Therefore, it's not now. Then confounding variables are there, and experiment must also control the possible confounding factor. This is a very important term to understand, that confounding variables are there. An experiment must also control the possible confounding factors. Confounding factors are the factors which are not in control, which will reduce reliability of the experiment. Okay, like what we discussed, that temperature is not the variable which we want to study. Okay. If the temperature changes, then results or effect of pH we may not prove properly. That outcome may be because of changed temperature. Therefore, the temperature will become confounding variable there. Now, confounding variables are any factors that would mar or that would reduce the accuracy or repeatability of the experiment or ability to interpret the results. Okay. Sometimes if you carry out experiment in Indian conditions, those experiments may not work in other countries where weather is different. Then you have to control the environmental conditions in India also, in other countries also. Or you have to mimic conditions, weather conditions which are there in India. Then only in other countries you can repeat that experiment. Similar thing happened to fermentation industry also. Fermentation may not work as expected in winter seasons or something like that. That is because the confounding factor, which is temperature and other things like moisture, humidity in the air, those will go on changing according to seasons. Okay. Confounding is commonly eliminated through scientific controls. Confounding is eliminated by matching the groups in scientific experiments or in randomized experiments through random assignment. Random assignments are necessary. Random assignments are there in which we'll assign the groups randomly to control and test. Okay. Those are matched experimental subjects. Some subjects will go to control group, some subjects will go to a random group, but to test group, treatment group. But each subject has equal opportunity, equal probability to get assigned to control treatment or to get assigned to test treatment. Okay. And this randomization is very essential. That's the base of experimental procedure. Okay. Randomization, you have to allocate your experimental subjects, research subjects, randomly to different treatments. Okay. Then only the individual differences in the experimental subjects or volunteers will not be in picture, will not be become confounding factors. And in this session, we'll stop here. In next session, we'll go on discussing this further. Experiment in engineering and physical science, experiments in biological sciences, and further things about experimentation we'll discuss in further sessions. And we will devote our much time on discussing what experiments are there, because in life sciences, experimental method is the most popular or most proper method, not most proper, but most used method for research. Thank you. If you like the video, please press the like button. If you aren't subscribed to my channel yet, subscribe to that and study further. Try to understand these concepts on your own. Thank you.